Okay, so today I'm going to be talking about parasitism in horses. There are some risk factors that can make your horse more prone to getting a parasitic colonization and subsequent infection. Certain climatic conditions and regions favor the hatching of the eggs and the development of larvae. These can include aspects such as temperature, moisture levels, changing of the seasons, and just geographically where you're keeping your horses. Temperature is also needs to be considered for optimal parasitic growth, along with if the larvae have a good nutrient supply. And this plays well into pasture and stable management techniques. To reduce the risk of your horses getting colonized by a parasite, you can plow and reseed your pastures. This will deposit certain eggs further into the ground where they can remain inaccessible for the horses. Because the majority of parasite eggs are passed through manure, using a rotational grazing strategy can reduce the risk of your horses coming into contact with either contaminated feed or contaminated fecal matter. More susceptible horses include young foals and older immunocompromised horses. They should have their stable environment cleaned routinely, and the proper treatment should be employed depending on how resistant these parasites are. Some signs and symptoms generally develop when a parasitic load is said to colonize the host. Parasitism is a major cause of recurrent colic cases. Colic is a broad term that refers to abdominal pain, but it can include things such as gas accumulation, paction, general discomfort that can prevent the animal from defecating normally. It could also possibly lead to the need of surgery. Playing well with colic is diarrhea, which, if left untreated, can lead to decreased body condition and decreased performance. Depending on the route of migration of the parasite, internal damage can occur. If the parasite burrows into the intestines, as seen in this picture right here, inflammation and hemorrhage can occur, leading to infections and the inability to properly absorb nutrients. Other common signs include a dull hair coat, pot belly, and general lethargy. These are a couple examples of some of the common internal parasites and worms that can affect your horse. The small strongyles are the most common intestinal parasite of adult horses. They are pictured right here. These strongyle larvae burrow into the walls of the intestines and the arteries that provide the main blood supply for the intestines. This can lead to blood clots and colic and inflammation, as mentioned earlier. Roundworms are pictured here, and they're mainly dangerous to horses because they can cause impaction. Horses can actually become immune to these parasites, so they typically affect foals that are 2 years old or less because their immune system hasn't had a chance to fully develop yet. Tapeworms are pictured here, along with lungworms are also very common. Stomach bots are in this last picture. They are the larvae of the botfly, so the female botfly will deposit her eggs onto the hair coat of the horse, which are ingested. When the horse licks itself, these can attach to the upper part of the stomach and cause ulcers. While each individual parasite has its own unique life cycle, the overall progression is the same, and that includes the hatching of the eggs, the development of the larva, migration through the host, and then maturation into adults, which can then lay their eggs and start the cycle over again. The main differences arise in the path of the migration that the larva takes, or if they return to the original site of infection to complete their life cycle. S. vulgaris is one of the three primary species of large strongyles that infect the horse, and I have, using this as an example of one life cycle, the beginning and end is pretty much that the eggs are passed into fecal matter. The eggs then develop into larvae in a couple stages where they enter the infective stage. This is when the eggs are ingested. They then colonize the large intestine, migrate through the blood supply, and then complete their life cycle by returning back to the intestines, where the adults are mature and can lay their eggs, start the cycle over again. Management techniques will greatly help to control the spread of parasites throughout your farm. Fecal examinations include fecal flotations and fecal egg counts. These are done at a laboratory to identify the type and the number of parasite eggs. This bottom left picture is an example of what you can determine with the fecal flotation. Under a microscope, you can tell the types of eggs that are present. And with a fecal egg count, you identify the number of parasite eggs. So it will allow the owner to know the extent to which its horses and pastures are affected. The key to preventing parasitic colonization in your horse is to disrupt the life cycle of the parasite before it gets ingested. Management techniques, as mentioned before, play a large role in this. Stalls and stables should be sterilized routinely. The pasture should be plowed to prevent overgrazing. And the manure should be removed from the pastures if at all possible. Using rotational grazing strategies will help with overgrazing as well, and allowing ruminants to rotate in on the grazing regimen will decrease the amount of infective larvae that the horses can ingest because they're often species specific. Anthelmintics are chemicals also called antiparasitics and dewormers. They each have their own mode of action. They're used to remove internal parasites and are divided into six classes. The most common include avermectins, benzimidols, and pyrimides. They can either be given orally as a paste, as a drench, or they can be added into the feed. Every class could potentially be more efficient at removing one specific type of parasite, so the correct deworming protocol should be put in place to decrease the incidence of resistance. And an example of a deworming protocol is seen here. The age of the horse must be taken into consideration, as well as the class used in each deworming so as to prevent resistance.
And there's your references.
Okay, very good. I didn't